Welcome back, Cocaholics. Another episode of Foul Mouth Fishing. And today is another one of our retail red videos. So I took a little day trip back to my hometown. And while I was there, I hit up Dick's Sporting Goods out of my neck of the woods, about 2 hours away from where I live now. And lo and behold, they had some boxes down there, number boxes that we don't get around my neck of the woods. So while I was down there, I picked up one of these Elite MTB retail red boxes, and what you can't see, or maybe you can get a glimpse, I got a couple of the green boxes in the standard bass kit because they were having a sale on those. And so today we're going to tear into one of these and take a look at what you get in your MTB store boxes. Stay tuned. So MTB is a mail order subscription package deal. You pay a monthly fee and you'll get your choice of a standard, elite, or a pro tier, pro being the middle, standard being the bottom tier, first tier, and then elite being their top tier. And they have a variety of different styles, panfish baits, bottom water like catfish, and of course bass, which is my genre. But while they've really been strong on the mail order side, they recently, last few years, came out with these retail packages where they throw a bunch of baits into the same boxes, put these nice little skins on the outside, and they've numbered them. So I thought it was fun to just start doing a few of these every once in a while. And this time, when I stopped by the Dick's that's not so local to me, they had boxes up in the 100s. Basically, the Dick's Sporting Goods near me, the two of them in close proximity, they don't really exceed the 70s, 70, 80s. You might see like an 86 or an 85. But up at the other neck of the woods where I grew up, they had 90s and they had a few in the 100s. So they were also running a deal, a promotion. It might still be good. Where if you buy two of the standard green boxes, the Pro Bass Box, that's not Pro, excuse me, the standard Bass Box. Normally they're, I think they're $29.99 a piece. But they're doing a 2-for-$35 deal, so instead of paying $40-odd dollars plus tax, you're paying $35. So that's not bad. But today, we're going to crack into the Elite version, because that's my tier for my mail order. So I already opened it up here. And let's see what we got. These come with just this outside sheath. The inside just goes back to the standard bland MTB beige. And what do we got today? All right. Oh, there's something right on the top that is freaking awesome. Okay, we got ourselves a MTB sticker. We got one of these in our mail orders back in the day. The buckaroo bass there. I like that. That's cool. They do come with a what's inside card. It doesn't give you a price, but it does give you a list of the items that are supposed to be in the box, which is really cool because you know that you're getting the items that were supposed to be supplied. This one has 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 baits. And they do list on the package real quick an average. So this is 9 to 11 in the Elite. The standards are 5 to 6 items in a box. See right there, 5 to 6. And I think the Pro is like 7 to 9, I think, something like that. But, so we got right off the top a big ticket item from Livingston Lures. This is the Howler DMC. So Livingston Lures, it is a computer chip lip crankbait. They call it their Howler DMC. DMC is digital microchip. It is their bait fish sound system. So basically the way this works is once water contacts the two treble hooks, it'll short circuit across, connect the system inside, and it'll give off an electronic bait sound, like chirping, kind of crickety kind of sound that is supposed to emulate dying bait fish subsurface. So down in the water, as you're ripping this along, it should give you that chirping sound, and that will then hopefully clue in the fish. I think it's a bit gimmicky on something like a crankbait. I mean, there is the cadence of pausing a crankbait. Jerk baits, definitely. You know, jerk, 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 pause. Wait your 6, 8, 10 seconds. Jerk, jerk, pause. So the pause is when I think that these electronic bait sounds really do shine in a bait. Now, if you have something like the acoustic sound, the wave systems that bass anglers are putting on their boats, that's a little different. I mean, that's sending out a sound constantly to bring them in towards the boat. With this, throw it out, and you're there, and then you've cast it somewhere else. So, you know, take it as it may. I do think it potentially works. I mean, the system works for the hydro sound systems that they put underneath boats. But as far as baits go, I think, to me personally, I'm more in tune to something like a jerk bait rather than a crank bait. For me, for my money, I rather get a silent crankbait, because I always, personally, I believe crankbaits shine deflecting off of something and then stopping. It's when it deflects and it takes a sharp, odd transition from its normal cadence and normal projection, that's when I feel that most bass or predatory fish strike them. But that be as it may, not bad. We do know Livingston Lures puts out high price, high ticket items. It's a cool color. They call this melon shad, basically chartreuse, sea blue, sky bluish kind of teal top. It is 0.57 ounces, so just over half an ounce, 2.48 inches long. This is a 5-foot diver, and electronic bait fish sound features S and C. S stands for electronic bait fish sound. C stands for smart chip. Electronic bait fish sound. So that's pretty cool. Like I say, not bad. Really awesome. You get something like a crankbait in a box. That's always good. Definitely going to have fun with that. Next up, from Yozuri, another high-name brand, we have a Yozuri's 3DP knuckle bait. Now, here's something you don't want to see in this box. This is truly a gimmicky bait. Oh, well, it's a new color to me. So I have this in like a chartreuse yellow, I have this in black, and I have this in white, and now I've got it in basically like the fire crawl color, their version, R1302, so red 1302 color. So this is a smaller version of the Yozuri, I think. I think the other Yozuris are a little bit longer wire than this. But basically it's a spinner bait, but instead of having a Colorado, Willow, or Combo, you've got this sound ball, which is basically a 3/4 sphere. And in this one, because it's a solid tone, it's not the prism. This one has a little knuckle ball in there, a little BB inside this round thing that's supposed to give off a little bit of extra sound, rattle. They do have great hooks. They have great, great heads. Awesome for swimming through cover. I will say that. It's just this part of the aspect of it. I haven't heard, nor have I had any success catching anything on them. I do like this color. I think this is going to be great as a fire crawl style. And the fact that these come with a spun wire and a split ring, you can certainly pop this off and get yourself a nice mid-sized willow leaf and throw that on here, or a nice, I wouldn't even go with you can go with any blade really that you'd like, anything you prefer. They're good. It's put a good trailer on it. You can skip this under docks really easy. Like I said, that head on it is amazing for getting through grass lines. They aren't exactly weedless, so keep that in mind. But there are ways to make it weedless, which I might later on down the road give you a couple of hints and tips for a non-weedless spinnerbait or crank or buzzbait, how to turn this hook by adding a little something to this wire here and make it a weedless presentation. Definitely save you getting hung up in high grass lines. So that's cool. So two high-tier, high-price items, one both gimmicky, one more useful than gimmicky, one way more gimmicky than useful. Next, Perfection Lures, another great, great, great company. Something I've never had. Perfection Lures Ned Rig, pre-rigged kit, ready to go, with an 1/8 ounce green pumpkin, Ned head, you got two Ned head hooks, and you've got 5 soft plastics to go with it. So we've got a full kit for a Ned rig. That is freaking awesome. I do like that a lot. So this box number 99 here, number 99, is definitely a go-getter. If you see one in your local store, that's pretty darn awesome. I like that. That's worth the money right there. All right, so Perfection Lures also has the David Dudley-inspired jig heads. They stand up awesome. They have these little antennae, so when they land in soft turn or grass lines or muddy bottoms or rocky bottoms, it doesn't matter. They really do set your soft plastics in a very nice upright position. And they do help also feel the bottom. So if you don't have depth finders or anything like that and you really want to old school tick across the bottom to get your kind of topography underwater, to map it in your mind, they do work very well for that. Next, it wouldn't be a box without something from these guys from MTB. The Guggen Squad. We've got a Filthy Frog. So they got their frog. I think I have this one. So we've got the frog in Nightclub. I believe it's Nightclub, right? The all black one. So, yep, Nightclub. This is their 2.5 inch, 5/8 ounce soft body frog. Definitely going into some giveaway because I already have a couple of the Filthy Frogs in a couple of the colors, and I'm 99.9% sure I've got Night Frog or Nightclub. Not going to go too deep into depth. It's a soft plastic frog. Every frog, you can go to a million different companies. Really, when I look at them, I look at color, black, white, green. That's it. I'm emulating a black shape shadow in an overcast or sunny day, a white shadow, or a green color for emulating an actual frog. That's all belly tones. I don't care about the back. I don't care if it says eat me on the rear. They're not going to see that. If they're seeing that, it means the frog's a poor frog because it's landing upside down, and you don't want that. You want a frog to keel, land on top of the pads, and be able to scoot properly. Their soft plastic's really good. It does compress nicely. I do prone their hooks up a little bit more out of the package, but that's just me. Take that as it may. Really, what I look for is colors and the plastic consistency and the hook direction. I don't even so much pay attention to the gauge of wire on the hook, because you can change up what line you're using. If the hook is a very thin wire, downsize your line, throw it on something that's rigged with, you know, a 6 or 8 pound test. If it's a stout hook, like a, you know, a big gaffin jig hook, for like a punching and flipping style hook, gauge wise, then you can go up to your 15, 18, 16, 20 pound test lines. So that's cool. All right, almost halfway done. Biospawn Plasma Tails. These are cool. What color did we get this one? Ooh. Well, that stinks. Ah, I'm disappointed. They took the plasma out of the plasma tail. All right, so this is a Biospawn plasma tail in solid black. Solid black. There's no added color. I have them in, like, the green pumpkin with the chartreuse tip. I have them in, like, another color. Well, I think it's red with a brilliant blue tip, and this is just black. This is just a black worm. Great for muddy water, awesome bait, but it's not a plasma tail if you don't put plasma. This is something, if they're going to do black, they should do black and cream, like white, like bright, brilliant white, so you have this like stark black and white, you know what I mean, tip, but, or even a red tip. But anyway, awesome to have. I do always like throwing tails, and these can be thrown straight up on a Texas rig style or finessed. They work awesome, so I do like them. And they're Biospawn from Ketchco, really good plastics that they put out. So that I'm not mad about either. Alrighty, Samantis Baits Swimantis. Oh, Samantis Swimantis. So that's not them. That's this box down here. There we go. All right, so we got a small package of 5 little soft plastics. They call their Swim Mantis. All right, and these are little tiny paddle tails. Okay, they've got these little tiny finesse paddle tails. Nice thick heads, good meat in there for your hook. It does have a hook depression, I won't say hook slot, but a hook depression between the two shoulders here to settle your hook in to keep it weedless. And it does have a hook slot on the belly, on the keel side, to make penetration a lot easier once the hook does grab a hold of it. That's pretty cool. I like those. I don't know. I think I have a lot of similar sizes, so I'm probably going to throw this into a box as well for somebody to have fun with. Green pumpkin, always a killer color, and something in this size and shape is a good profile. Paddle tails are always good. You can swim them weightless on just a hook. You can put these on a swim jig head. You can clip them down as a trailer to almost anything. So this is a good size. I think it's about a 2.5-inch, 2-inch size. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. That's definitely somebody to get some good use out of that as well. Buddha bait. Buddha baits baby mama. Buddha baits baby mama. All right. So this is, I guess, like a craw. Well, that's an interesting trailer. Okay. So you've got your paddles on the side here, your craw cut. Definitely smell the Buddha bait garlic. And that is a French fry, an oversized French fry style body. That is an awesome, awesome looking trailer for a jig head. And I'd actually use this for punching and flipping because it's beefy enough. You can get your hook in there. It's not going to tear off real easy. And it's got a slim enough vertical profile that it should punch through pretty stout grass cover pretty nicely. And anything that you can get through grass cover as a punching bait, but still has a lot of appendages for flash, flutter, and flare, that's always good in my eye, so in my mind. So that's pretty cool. And this is a big pack. I say there's what? Let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8. I think there's 10 or 12 in here. Between 10 and 12. That is nice. Big fat pack of big fat baits. 4-inch baby mamas. So that's a punching and flipping bait if I ever did see one. I like that. I like that a lot. I'm going to definitely have fun throwing those. All right, 2 to go. 1 is terminal tackle, so I'll get to that real quick. They gave us a pack of stickies, EWGs, again, a Catchco brand. This is 3-aught size, 3-pack of hooks. I'll keep those aside for somebody. Stickies, oh, awesome hooks, awesome hooks. They're really sharp. And they don't bend out real easy. They've been good. If you know what you're doing and you're playing your fish right, they hold up phenomenal. And the last soft plastic is, again, from Carl's Amazing Baits. This is their varmint, which is their beaver, craw, rodent bait, combo style bait. But it's a small little beaver-esque bait, similar to that Buddha bait over there with your appendages, but that one had a far more pronounced craw trailer tip. This has got more of the beaver flat tail, does break off, and it does have little, emulations of craw, craw graspers, but it's more, for me, this is more something that I use as a beaver style. I don't normally tear these off, although, like I said, you can. I keep them together, typically. I also keep a jar of Mend-It, which is a great thing. Go to Tackle Warehouse. If you fish a lot of soft plastic swim baits, especially like I do for fishing for muskie or pike or anything like that, toothy critters, a bottle of Mend-It for soft plastics, it's basically super glue that's flexible and designed specifically for plastisols. So it doesn't get hard and crunchy and tear or eat or melt your soft plastic. It melts it. It welds it chemically, but it doesn't continue to keep burning it away. And paint it on, let it get a little tacky, stick them together, hold it there for a minute or so, a couple of seconds, and you have basically a brand new bait. And in some instances, I've ended up with putting it on places that weren't torn. And like welding, the parts that have been repaired were stronger than the main bait. So I do love that about it. I use it to hold hooks in place on soft plastics often as well, because it'll melt the plastisol around the hook shank and kind of glue it and adhere it tighter to it so it doesn't slide as much as possible. That being said, so look that up. Mend It by Tackle Warehouse has it. A lot of companies have it. You can get it on Amazon too, I'm sure. I'll probably do exactly that. I'll take a little Mend It and I'll stick it down that seam and I'll hold this together and turn this right back into a beaver tail as if I had never torn those two little tabs from those appendages away. Awesome bait. That's the last item in here. It is a sample bait bag. There's only three in here, which is depressing. Four. Don't want to be inaccurate. So we got four of these little guys in here. Again, coming from a Carl's, a Ketchco brand. Ketchco brand. Obviously, the Stickies, the Googans, Ketchco brand. So we got four guaranteed Ketchco products straight out of Carl's. And then we have five or six. Six. Yep. Because there's nine in here? There's nine. So five, six, seven, eight, nine. Yeah, five that were other brands, major manufacturers. That said, there's a couple things in here that are definitely going away in our boxes for our giveaways, as always. So tell me what you think. What do you think about 99? I'm actually very impressed. If I ever come across another Elite 99 box, I'm not going to hesitate to snatch it up. They are a little bit pricey, but they're comparative to the ones that I pay at $45 or $44 and some change for my mail order. And this is, you know, you forget, you lost yours in the mail, you didn't get one this month, or you don't have a subscription, or you left it at home and you're out on a trip, you can run to the store and grab it and have baits right there up and down the water column. You've got your knuckle bait, which is good for buzzing across the surface or going subsurface. We've got the poppin' frog, the midnight frog from Googans. There's your top water. You've got the crankbait, the square bill. That's your water column depths. You've got soft plastics you can run on any depth, including the worms that you can, you know, vertically jig on a wacky rig. The Buddha baits, which you can crawl down on the bottom. The only thing this was missing is if it had an actual jig trailer for the bottom, but they got the bottom baits covered too when they've got these Ned rigs, because these will go popping up and down on the bottom. So, every single section of the water column, very, very well covered, and multi-styles of baits, of bait presentations, from finesse to more high action, reaction, as it were, presentations. So, I gotta say, this is a quality box, in my opinion. And with that said, I invite you to tell me what you think. I do have a new giveaway going to start soon. I have my Christmas in July coming up. The big box is back there. I will pick a day eventually and randomly generate a winner. So to be eligible for the Christmas in July giveaway, it's really quite simple. You gotta be subscribed to this channel. Because as it stands, there's like two-thirds of the people who watch are not subscribed. They just, randomly come across. So only 34% of you actually care. It means a lot. But the rest of you, what do I got to do? What do I got to do to get you to subscribe? So you got to be subscribed. You have to have me in your list of subscriptions visible publicly on your YouTube channel, so when I go and click over and see that you have a list of people you subscribe to, I don't care what they are, but if I'm somewhere in there, then you're eligible. If I'm not in there, I can't see it, then you can't win, because this is quite a large prize, quite a large cost in shipping, and quite a valuable package in the number of items and things that are in there. I'm just going to randomly pick a video from some point between when I announced this and when I announced when the giveaway is going to be. And it's not necessarily going to be the Christmas in July giveaway announcement video, but I'm going to pick one video at random that I had posted between the announcement when I was going to start the Christmas in July giveaway, as I went through and added baits and you saw certain things come out of packages and certain random just videos when I just added baits, and the video itself when I announce about what prizes are going to be in there. I'm going to show a little bit. I'm still not going to open up the whole box and show everything, but I'll give you a glimpse of a lot of the items that are going to come in it. And I'm just going to pick a random person from the comments. So this is giving you an opportunity to go back, watch my videos all the way through, and comment on videos. So that's the key. Comment on videos. Throw some time and learn some stuff about me. See some of the videos that I've posted. Get a glimpse of other boxes and things from the past, different wares and items. And sometimes I throw in tips and things, like today with the mending. So there's always a chance to learn something from me, as I try to learn a lot from all of you. I do every day. So I appreciate the spending a little bit of time with me. And that being said, that's going to end it for this one. Y'all have a good day. Have a happy and healthy 4th of July weekend. And as always, from me to you, peace. And I'll catch you on the next cast.